Hey, Business Builder Campers, I got a friend, not a friend, my daughter, who is going to help us today. Who's there? Come in, Molly.
Okay.
Oh, what do you have?
A package.
A package. Where's it from?
Colorado?
Colorado. Who do we know that lives in Colorado?
What's his name?
Jack.
Dad.
Jack Justice lives in Colorado. And what did he eat at our house?
What?
What did he eat everything? Remember?
Who's that?
He ate all the pretzels, right?
Yeah.
Oh, look. So it's a package that came in the mail from Jack Justice and Ramblin' Jackson. It's from Honeyville. So it's in Colorado, and Jack's business is in Colorado. And when I open it up, here's what's important. So it's mail. Can you start opening it and see what's in there, Molly? So you can adjust it down. So it's a nice package. It's valuable. And Molly's gonna work on opening it. What's in there?
I don't know what's in here.
I don't know what's in there. Let's see. What do you got?
Let's see. I can't see. Cherry rhubarb jam.
Jam? Some jam? Yeah.
Cinnamon whip wildflower jam.
Cinnamon whipped wildflower jam. So it's a
Honey.
bunch of honey and jams and jellies and things like that. And so here's what came with it. This is important. This is a lumpy mail package. So you open it up and you see that it's from Jack and Kara Justice, and it says visit ramblinjackson.com/harvest. So I encourage you to go there because. And in fact, Molly and I, when we stopped in the video, I'm going to share the video with her so she can see Jack in the video he prepared. So this went out to a targeted list of clients that have been on Jack's email list, some of them for years. And Jack and Robert, his top of funnel salesperson there, are monitoring the activity of these accounts. So when they open emails, who's active, maybe who have we had a preliminary conversation with over the last period of time? Who do we know is a likely buyer that's ripe? So this is Jack's Ripe Apples campaign. And last year he actually did apples, but this year there was a frost in Colorado, so we had to do honey and jelly and things like that instead of apples. This is a campaign targeting 50 businesses. What's that one? Honeyaki? Stinging marinade. That sounds good. Some honeyaki. So he's targeting these 50 accounts, right? And they've been active. He knows who they are. So he's going to send them a valuable lumpy mail. I first learned about lumpy mail from a guy named John Goldman, who used to send like garbage cans in the mail, lumpy packages. And we use that at Preferred Warranties to target a very specific list of high value business owners that we wanted to work with. So Jack's doing the same. He works with landscapers, and he wants landscapers who want to build a website with him and do an initial project and then be an ongoing residual client. So he's targeting him, sending this lumpy mail. And if you go to ramblinjackson.com/harvest, you'll get to see that he prepared a special video and put an offer in there so that they take the next step. And it says, "Dear Landscaping Warrior, happy autumn. It's harvest time, and the Ramblin' Jackson team is here with a gift and an important timely message. Is there a recession coming? Have people changed how they buy, and have you adapted? See the shocking truth behind what one landscaper did in the fall to make an additional $1 million the following spring in the video I made for you at ramblinjackson.com/harvest. In the meantime, we hope you enjoy these fresh Colorado products with your family, Jack and Kara Justice." So you get this nice package in the mail from Colorado. You're already a little bit warm. You know who Ramblin' Jackson is. And then you get that specific message. Who wouldn't want to go see the secrets behind an additional $1 million the following spring? And if you go to that page, you'll see how Jack built a specific offer just for the people getting this that makes it likely that they're going to click and want to go farther. Now, the other part of a campaign like this is you got to track the results and the steps, and you got to know what you're going to do. So you need Jack has somebody who is designated to follow up. You don't want to send a This is expensive. And Jack, thanks, man. I'm loving this. You wouldn't want to send a package like this without doing thorough, immediate follow-up, right? So you campaign it out where step one, send the box. Step two, call, ask if they got it, work to schedule an appointment. Step three, send a reminder postcard with the link, with the, hey, we haven't heard from you. Step four, call again. Step five, email. Step six, connect by LinkedIn. Step seven, connect by and follow by Instagram. What else? Facebook, more phone messages, whatever you got to do to try to get them engaged because you send them a high value package. And most people, because of the law of reciprocity and the law of just being a good human, are at least going to have a conversation with you. And they're going to feel goodwill towards you and your company. And even if they don't do business with you now, they will do business down the road. So getting the right list, having the right people on the list, send a valuable package, know how you're going to follow up, engineer the next action for what, you know, follows and how you want them to engage with you. Those are the important things. That's it. Lumpy Mail 101. Molly, thanks for the help. Which one do you think we should eat first? Colorado Peach Raspberry Jam is the winner. Take care. Bye.